Hi, this is Bob from Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff, and if you're looking for an online Toughbook community that gives tips, tricks, and support, hit the subscribe and bell button for notifications of all our upcoming videos. So stay tuned. Thanks for joining us for the episode today. Today we're going to be taking some Q&A. Well, I'm going to be doing some answering to some questions from our viewers on the Panasonic Toughbook CF-C2. And our first question, which is actually a two-part question, comes from Eugenie Chirkoff. And his first part of the question is, which RAM cards are supported? And you know what, Eugenie, I'm going to be answering that in the next question in more detail. So I'll take your second part of the question, which is, can I use and I don't know how to pronounce this, but Huawei, H-U-A-W-E-I, card, which is an ME906E, and he says, appreciate the help. Well, I did a little research for you, and number one, that's not a supported card for the from Panasonic for the CF-C2. However, there is some information on the web that states that depending on what version you have, it can work. So my advice to you is give it a shot, install it, see if it works for you. It'll depend on the version. So it's kind of a shot in the dark. I don't know the specific versions, but a little bit of research on the web and you'll find out a lot just like I did. The next question is, and this is also going back to Eugene's question, is from Alder Langria. What is the RAM memory? For example, DDR2, DDR3, and what does the MK mean? Well, those are two questions actually. And let me talk about the RAM memory. So the RAM memory, and I have it written down, is used in this unit, is the DDR3 P3L 10600 or the 12800. The 12800 is the better choice, but they both work in the CF-C2. Now, the C2 can take 16 gigs of RAM, but let's keep in mind that one of the slots to upgrade is really easy to get to on the bottom, but the other one is underneath the keyboard and you have to remove the top. It's a little more difficult to put that other stick of RAM in. So if you need to put 2.8s in, you're gonna be doing a lot of dismantling in order to make it happen. As far as what is MK and what does that mean? So that is the generation of Toughbook. MK1 would be first generation, MK2 is third, second generation, so on and so forth. As Panasonic was making the model, a new processor would come out from Intel, the next version. So like an i5 third gen, they would install, would make it an MK3, and then they would make the next generation would be whenever the i5 fourth gen processor came out, they would then make that the MK4. So you would just, as they progressed with the processor, they would also change different parts within the unit to upgrade it to more modern technology. And that's how they differentiated the different units, was just with that MK, which stands for generation in their minds. So that's what they did on that. The next question comes from Young Request. Any CPU upgrades? Well, Young Request, I got some bad news for you. The processor or CPU on the CF-C2 is soldered to the motherboard, and I'm unaware of any way to upgrade that processor to anything else. Unfortunately, the answer to your question is no. My next question comes from King Bras. And can you please explain the internal battery? Sometimes I can swap it out without turning it off. So what you're experiencing is they have a small battery in the C2 that allows you to pull the battery out for a very short period of time and put a new battery in and still have the laptop on. It's just a secondary battery. It sits on the motherboard. It's just a glorified capacitor that holds a charge just long enough for you to swap batteries out. That's one of the nice features of the CF-C2. Well, I think I have one more question. So the next question comes from Antoine Coton. For the CF-C2, are there any specific drivers? No. Well, the drivers that you need is going to depend on the operating system that you're loading on there. I do know that all the way up to Windows 7, you can get those drivers right off of Panasonic support website. You just go to Panasonic.com and click on support. If you're loading Windows 10, you may have to use Vista drivers, or sometimes the Windows 7 drivers work. But I do know that there's not very many, there's not much problem if you had to load Windows 10 on that unit. You should easily be able to find the drivers with no problem. Well, that's all the questions I got to go over with you today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys next week.